بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، اللهم ربنا تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا ودعاءنا، اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك من النيران في هذا الشهر الكريم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا، اللهم عافنا يا ربنا واعف عنا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our worship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those being gifted this month by being freeing forever from the doom of the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, the one who forgive, to pardon us as he loves subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive. The suwar that we are in now are one of the very heavy words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have revealed. And we say heavy words because they are all about, mainly about the oneness of Allah, about the attributes of Allah, and the whole Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, are heavy words. قَالَ إِنَّا سَنُلْقِي عَلَيْكَ قَوْلًا ثَقِيلًا. It is, or they are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The words of Allah, which is mean that the words of Allah has the attributes of Allah. The ultimate truth, the complete and the high speak in perfection. It is relevant, universal, comprehensive. And, you know, it is everlasting. So these are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ayat that we are studying, mainly the last ayah that we have recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. You're going to die and everyone else, and they're going to die. وَإِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عِنْدَ رَبِّكُمْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ. And you're going to come in the day of judgment disputing and arguing. People today, all the creation around them does not give them the reflection and does not give them, you know, to inspire them to think about this whole perfect creation around them. Is going to come a day where this whole earth will not be able to produce anything. The whole life will stop to exist on this whole earth. However, this whole earth is going to be present as a witness in the day of judgment. That's why the one who look at the creation of the heaven and the earth as invitation and command from Allah and command from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to reflect on this creation. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Indeed, in the creation of the heaven and the earth, and the day and the night, how they alternate, are signs of people of understanding. And we said that the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, woe to the one who reads this ayat and does not think about them and does not ponder upon them. In the other ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال أَفَلَمْ يَرَوْا إِلَى مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Do not they see what is between their hand from the heaven and the earth and what's behind them? So when you walk, just stop and look up and look in front of you and then look back. He said, do they guarantee that might Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have the earth to swallow them? Or a chunk from the sky will fall on them? يَخْسِبْ بِهُمُ اللَّهُ الْأَرْضِ أَوْ يُسْقُطْ عَلَيْهِمْ كِسَفًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ مُنِيبٍ. And this is sign for people who go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to be able to have this part of the worship, of thinking, of pondering, part of your system, part of your ibadah, you have to be a person who is munib, الإنابة is to always go back to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Always go back to Allah. But how can we go back to Allah سبحانه وتعالى? Someone who can be distracted, you know, busy. Something is out of our control often. But someone, how can you be a munib person, a abd, a servant that is munib, a servant that is aware, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complimented Ibrahim alayhi salam with these two great values, and he is Halim too. The way is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you be always in remembrance of the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said toward the end of Surah Sad that we have finished, قال الله سبحانه قال واذكر في الكتاب إبراهيم وإسحاق ويعقوب أولو الأيدي والأبصار. أولو الأيدي, people who have the strength and you know in worshipping Allah, والأبصار, with that clear insight. إن أخلصناهم, we have gifted them with a very specific characteristic, is to always remember the hereafter. So remembering the hereafter, you know, into your day and make it part of your plan, that's what is going to help you to be a person munib. And you are munib, then it's going to help you reflect on the creation around you. Because if you do not reflect and think of the day of judgment and in the yawm al-qiyamah, we'll be kind of living, you know, a different life. You know, we are making a life that is not true. That's why the one who does not think as much as we should in the day of judgment will not have a high esteem to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِ. They didn't really give to Allah the esteem and the veneration that he should has. قال, والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة. The whole earth, it will be in his hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. قبضته is there in the land of resurrection. Everybody is going to see it. والسماوات مطويات بيمينه. It's like the whole heaven is like rolled up. Just to understand. Well, you know, when you think of the creation, how you know, insignificant we are, you know, to the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatest creation of Allah that he created is the throne, al-arsh. And the arsh is, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling us, is the ceiling of this universe. And the universe, there's many universes. There's the universe that we live in, and there's the universe beyond the time. Because we are in the sphere of the time, beyond the time that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam crossed when he went to Al-Isra and he saw Wal-Mi'raj, when he saw Al-Jannah. The Al-Arsh is as big as the example. When I say as big, we cannot, there is nothing to say as big as. But the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, don't you see, if you have a ring, and a ring that you throw it in a desert, imagine, take just a picture and go today and look as a desert, and subhanallah how big it is, and you throw in it a ring, can you find the ring inside the desert if you someone lost it? So this is the whole universe compared to the throne of Allah. The ring is the universe, and the throne of Allah is like the desert. So when it comes, the earth, قَالَ قَبْضَتِهِ, in his hand, and the whole heaven folded, and you're going to be there. And there is ayah, subhanAllah, every time I read, I cannot pass, you know, it's really, we need to share it with you. Every time we come, you know, we have to remind ourselves with this ayah. قَالَ وَلَوْ أَنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا وَمِثْلَهُ مَا. Now imagine you are in the day of judgment. Like Al-Imam Al-Muhasibi, he will take you to a journey just of imagining. قَالَ وَلَوْ أَنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ لَفْتَدَوْ بِهِ مِنْ عذاب يوم القيامة. If the, this transgressor, the people who didn't have any esteem to Allah, the people with all the signs around them, they didn't pay attention to their Creator, they're gonna come, they wish if they can have the whole earth, and the whole earth as a property, and one like it, to just give it a ransom to be saved from the doom of hellfire. So you see, dear brother, respects the sister, Allah's explained to us that whatever money you will have in this dunya is gonna not going to help you. The only thing that it helps you is the forgiveness. And we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every night forgiveness. And we're trying on Laylatul Qadr for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see us in this place with all our brother and sister, you know, on the net, to have ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this forgiveness. The only thing that can help us, save us, is that Allah will forgive us. Therefore, if we do not venerate Allah the way He should be venerated, and we have the high esteem to Him, then we are losing. إِنَّنَا مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. So imagine if you have all this. In the other ayah, قَالْ مِلْءُ الْأَرْضِ ذَهَبًا. If we'll bring the whole earth, can you have the whole earth is gold? The whole earth gold. It does like a lingo or two or 100 kilogram of gold. You bring the whole earth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rejected, because it does not have a value. قال وبدا لهم من الله ما لم يكونوا يحتسبون. This is what we need to be careful of. Abu al-Hasan al-Zahid, a whole night crying, reflecting on one ayah, when they sent one of his close friends to come, you know the story, and to just ask him, because his family, they didn't dare just to get in the night. He's praying, and they don't want to disturb him. They have to his friend. They said, maybe he has something. So he came, he knocked the door. He said, who is this? He said, so-and-so. He said, mashallah, enter. He said, you know, the whole family are really concerned. You've been crying there like hours. He said, alhamdulillah, I'm fine. He said, what happened? He said, it was an ayah that I was reading. He said, one ayah did for you this? He said, oh, yeah. He said, what this ayah? This is what we're going to read from Surah Az-Zumar. قال وَبَدَى لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يَكُونُوا يَحْتَسِبُونَ. And it appeared to them from Allah what they didn't really computed, what they didn't really expect. You go in there and you say, alhamdulillah, I'm a Muslim, a believer. Alhamdulillah, I did this, I prayed, and I did a lot of sadaqat, and I did, and I did, and I did. And then you come there, you don't find anything. It's like someone has an account and he feel like he's safe, you know, say this crisis people, I don't care, alhamdulillah, I'm fine. And then he check his balance, you know, his stocks and everything. Everything plunged, and suddenly he does not have anything. All the dreams that they have, you know, based on that money that he really owned. And then when he find out that everything is gone, imagine the situation of this person. And the situation of a person who come to the Day of Judgment, he will find or she will find the thing that they didn't calculate, they didn't expect, they think that they're doing good. But they came and they didn't find anything. And all of us, we are truly threatened by that. All of us. Don't say, alhamdulillah, we're making qiyam. We don't know. We don't know. If the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I don't say I'm going to Jannah except if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala embrace me in His mercy. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the King of the King, refused to get me in His mercy, I cannot do anything. وَبَدَى لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يَكُونُوا يَحْتَسِبُونَ. They didn't know. قُلْ هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا الَّذِينَ ظَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. Should I tell you the more astray in this life? That they went totally astray. They think that they're doing great. This is very difficult. Because When you come in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you cannot compare it to anything. It's not a king that you're going to speak to. It's not a president that you're going to talk to. It's not an elder. It's Allah. Allah who knows everything about you. We'll be shivering because the hellfire will be on the side. And you don't know, you might be dragged there. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to a person to be dragged to hellfire, the angel that will take him, the guardian, and he will be screaming, he said, have mercy on me. You know what the angel they say? Have mercy on you. If the most merciful is Allah, the most merciful, they didn't have mercy on you. He wants us to have mercy on you. The most merciful. There is no more merciful than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he didn't have mercy on you, who can have mercy? Who can? Akhwani, this is very serious. Especially reminding ourselves in Ramadan, people, they don't want to talk about this. This is very serious because this is our life. You cannot not think about this because this is your life. This is your life. If we think that we're going to die and then everything is fine afterward, like some faith they think, that's not right. That's wrong. That's a corrupted faith that we have. That's why you have to beg for the rahmah of Allah every day. You have to show humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day. That's why the necessity to be munib, it's not like an option. It is, as I said, is a necessity. You need to someone to think. When you go to your bed, you're dying. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're going to read it in the next rakah. Allah yatawaffa al-anfusa hina mawtiha. You go to die. You go to sleep. People, they're dreaming tomorrow it's going to have this and this and this. And you're dying, truly dying. Your soul get out. Is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he will to send it back, and if he will to hold it. That's why the Salaf, when we read the story of the Salaf, we think like, oh, this is too much. This is exaggeration. Exaggeration because our heart become like cold, like hard. A lady, she entered to the house of Al-Awza'i, Al-Imam Al-Awza'i. She talking to his wife. And then she looked on the side. There's a wet spot. She left. She said, oh, this is, you know, some of the kids who came. Maybe he did it. And you didn't see it. She said, no, no, no. That's the tears of the sheikh. Every night, he had the same thing. From Qiyam al-Layl. Al-Imam al-Awza'i, rahimahullah. That the wet spot that you see, that the tears of the sheikh. You know. It is a necessity, really. If you're going to die every night and we do not think about it, then really we are very corrupted. I'm sorry for the word. Let's let, you know, have tonight for everyone to be harsh on ourselves. If you wake up in the morning not thinking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a new gift, a new opportunity for tawbah, for inabah, for to be aware, to come back to Allah, to repent to Allah, to say, ya Allah, alhamdulillah, you give me today. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking about, the sunnah and the sunnah. And the sunnah is not in the form, it's not in what you wear or what how you look like. The sunnah is in this part that we are neglecting. Look the hadith of the Prophet, when you go to bed, he say, ya Allah, if you take my life, ya Allah, take it from those who are granted, you know, the blessing. Ya Allah, if you send back my life, فَحْفَظْهَا بِمَا حَفَظْتَ بِهِ عِبَادَكَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Oh, protect this soul as you do for your righteous servant. And when he wake up, he said, Alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا. Don't we hear? He gave us life after he caused us to die. It's a reality. This is our, it's not a belief. This is a reality. We say a belief, alhamdulillah. But this is the truth. No one who dies, he'll die. When we die, we become like more aware. The eyes will be hadid, sharp. I mean, we don't see anything. When you are in the grave, it's not like, you know, the grave, that subhanAllah, is a way how to express it. But it's totally different dimension. It's parallel to the life that we live. The people who died are not dead. The death is another way of existence, is another life. We call it the life behind the barzakh, behind them. Allah qala, barzakhun ila yawm yub'athun. The barzakh, قال حتى إذا جاء قال ربي أرجعون لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها ومن ورائهم from in front of them they have a barzakh, a barrier, a veil, so you cannot see what in this world and we cannot see in their what in their world. However, we call the shaheed is alive. Why the shaheed is alive? Because he's honored. He lived a life of a bliss. When you don't live, when you don't have a choice, we cannot, you know, do anything, that's not life. You are in a situation of waiting. And if you are a believer, you're going to be offered all the blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the people in the grave, when the first, there's three blowing in the trumpet. The first one of al-faza', the second one of the saq, and the first one, the third one of al-qiyam. The first one in surat an-naml, وَيَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَفَزَعَ. Everybody will be terrified in this whole universe, and they know that something is going. قَالَ, and then وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَسَائِقَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Everyone, not for in the heaven and the earth, except who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. Everyone will die. Then the third one, قال ثم نفخ فيه أخر. This is the third one. فإذا هم قيام ينظرون. Everyone open their eyes, standing, even the people in the grave, because when the saq, the second one, everyone will die. Everyone, even the people in the grave, they are have a life, they die. That's why قال ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى رب يمسو. قالوا يا ويل من بعثنا من مرقدنا. Because it happened, they said, that's it, this is the end of it. Because the disbeliever, they will be tortured in this life of the barzakh. Then when the nafkha, they said, this is the respite, this is the end, this is the good death that you would be wishing. But no, they said, من بعثنا من مرقدنا. And Allah at that time will say, لمن الملك اليوم, to whom the kingdom belong today. Nobody can answer. And Allah will answer, لله الواحد القهار. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the firmness on the path. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to empower us to be grateful to Him and grateful to all the gift He bestowed upon us and bestow upon our parents and family. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to do righteous actions that are pleased by Allah. So it's not, look, it's very important. It's not in the importance that I do righteous action. No, I have to do the righteous action and begging Allah to accept it. That's what Sulaiman said. أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي. This is what I have said. وَأَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا, and give me the ability to act righteous, تَرْضَى, that you pleased with it. Ibrahim عليه السلام, he's building the Kaaba, he say, يَا رَبِّي, oh Allah, تَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي, تَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the empowerment of being grateful to Allah and the right action that Allah will accept from us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect us among al-muttaqeen, among al-muttaqeen, tayyibin, إن شاء الله تعالى يا رب العالمين. وإلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله.